Here's the bad part. When you do testing to that extent, you're going to find more people. You're going to find more cases. So I said to my people, slow the testing down, please.
To my knowledge, none of us have ever been told to slow down on testing. That just is a fact. In fact, we will be doing more testing.
Go back a week, 50 days, the strongest 50 days in stock market history. This is during, hopefully, the end of the pandemic.
I have said multiple times publicly that we are still in the middle of the first wave. So before you start talking about what a second wave is, what we'd like to do is to get this outbreak under control over the next couple of months.
I spoke with the governor of Texas, where they've done a fantastic job, and he said they have had some outbreaks in prisons, and that's where their numbers went out, and the numbers changed a little bit because of the prison population, but he's got it in great shape. Texas, Florida's doing very well, Georgia's doing very well. We have tremendous numbers.
Right now, the next couple of weeks are going to be critical in our ability to address those surgings that we're seeing in Florida, in Texas, in Arizona, and in other states. They're not the only ones that are having a difficulty.
And we're going to be in Oklahoma, and it's a crowd like I guess nobody's seen before. We have tremendous requests for tickets like I think probably has never happened politically before.
I'll say it yet again, that you should not congregate in crowds. You should keep distance. And even though many people, for a variety of reasons, do not listen to the, not suggestion, but plea to not congregate in crowds, some people are going to do that anyway. If you do, please wear a mask.
And it's one of the reasons we did so well before the plague, and we're doing so well after the plague. It's going away.
Certainly will be coronavirus infections in the fall and winter because the virus is not going to disappear.
Oh, I think they should open the schools, absolutely. I think they should. And it's had very little impact on young people. And I think that if you're an instructor, if you're a teacher, a professor, and you're over a certain age, like let's say 65, or maybe even if you want to be conservative, 60, perhaps you want to stay out for a little while longer. But I think you should absolutely open the schools.
And we really better be very careful, particularly when it comes to children, because the more and more we learn, we're seeing things about what this virus can do that we didn't see from the studies in China or in Europe. For example, right now, children presenting with COVID-19, who actually have a very strange inflammatory syndrome, very similar to Kawasaki's syndrome. I think we better be careful if we are not cavalier in thinking that children are completely immune to the deleterious effects.
But there's a theory that in April, when it gets warm, historically, that has been able to kill the virus.
We do not know what this virus is going to do. We would hope that as we get to warmer weather, it would go down. But we can't proceed under that assumption.
It's a little like the regular flu that we have flu shots for. And we'll essentially have a flu shot for this in a fairly quick manner.
Which means it is 10 times more lethal than the seasonal flu.
It's going to disappear. One day it's like a miracle. It will disappear.
So I can say we will see more cases and things will get worse than they are right now.
I think, importantly, anybody right now and yesterday, anybody that needs a test gets a test. They're there. They have the test.
The idea of anybody getting it easily, the way people in other countries are doing it, we're not set up for that. Do I think we should be? Yes, but we're not.
We don't want everybody to go out and get a test because there's no reason for it. Yeah.
So is that a way of saying we are not yet at a point where we are meeting the demand pressure?
Well, the answer is yes, John. We are not there yet because otherwise people would be never calling up saying they can't get a test.
So you have remdesivir and you have chloroquine and hydroxychloroquine. So those are two that are out now, essentially approved for prescribed use. And I think it's going to be very exciting. I think it could be a game changer, and maybe not.
Not totally sure what the president was referring to, but I believe he's referring to a report that used both hydroxychloroquine and azithromycin together to have some possibility of being in effect. Many of the things that you hear out there are what I had called anecdotal reports. They may be true, but they're anecdotal. The president is talking about hope for people.
Mr. President, so ultimately, will you take Dr. Fauci's recommendation on this, or are you thinking he's just looking at one set of inputs?
I would certainly, he's very important to me, and I will be listening to him.